It's 2 a.m. and you're still tossing and turning in bed. You've counted so many sheep jumping over the fence, they could populate a little European country. You've read 100 pages of advanced physics for fun. Even 2 cups of relaxing mint tea didn't help you. You turn on the TV, hoping to find some boring show to fall asleep to. As you're switching through the channels, you see a girl put a glass of water under her bed, and voila! She falls asleep with a happy smile on her face some minutes later. The host explains that in feng shui, water symbolizes wealth and perfection. It transforms from liquid to solid form and gas quickly and flows freely. It helps in new beginnings and carries some coded information in it. And it helps you sleep safe and sound because it absorbs negative energy. You can check to see if you have trouble falling asleep because of negative vibes with a simple test. Leave a glass of water under your bed overnight and check it in the morning. If you find bubbles in it or it's clouded, it's those bad vibes the water has taken from the bedroom. Even if you see no bubbles in the morning, you should still flush the water down the drain and get a refill for the next night. The water has probably just absorbed all the negativity. You feel a little skeptical about this ritual. But you also only have 4 hours to sleep before the alarm goes off, so you decide to try it. Anyway, leaving open cups of water around the room can make the air a bit more humid, and that's definitely not bad. Some minutes later, you finally fall asleep. When you wake up the next morning, you see bubbles in the glass and wash all those negative vibes down the drain. You're still not sure if it was the water trick that helped you, or you were just that tired. So you decide to ask your colleagues what helps them fall asleep. Mrs. Smith, who has 3 kids, says playing with them is her sleep savior. Blowing bubbles, for example, is a deep breathing exercise. It relaxes your body and takes your mind off problems that distract you from going to sleep. She also recommends humming like a bee. You know, bees don't hum, they buzz, but you go along with it. It's like a spa for your mind and nervous system, she says, and it turns on the production of melatonin, the sleep hormone, and serotonin, the feel-good one. To make it work, you gotta lay down on your bed, close your mouth, inhale through the nose, and hum like a bee on an exhale. Do this for about 10 minutes before sleep. Mrs. Smith says both methods work like magic. Steve, the social media guy, is a real music addict. He says he only falls asleep to Beethoven. Listening to music for 25 to 60 minutes before bed works miracles for those who have insomnia. It doesn't have to be Ludwig and the like. When you do it regularly, your brain will take it as a before-bed ritual, and you'll fall asleep even faster. Suddenly, you remember you read somewhere that the sound of frying bacon has a similar effect. You look it up. Yep, science has said the comforting and repetitive sound of bacon cooking sends some relaxing vibes to your brain. It's perfect for falling asleep and as white noise while you're working and need to focus. You don't have to fry bacon before bed. Listening to a recording will do it. Speaking of bacon, it's lunchtime. You all get together and start discussing your diets. It turns out certain foods can also help you drift off. The secret is to have Brenner. That's breakfast for dinner. Bananas help your muscles relax thanks to potassium. Eggs are rich in protein that helps healthy sleep. Almonds slow down your heart rate a bit. Oats and honey send the right amount of melatonin toward your brain. Foods you should avoid before going to sleep, unless you want to be awake all night, are cheese, fatty food, all things spicy, and of course, coffee. Work is done for the day. It's time to hit the gym. Mike, your fitness coach, has a sporty solution. It's progressive muscle relaxation. Your muscles that have been working all day also need to unwind, just like your mind. You can start from your head and move down to your toes or go in the opposite direction. Begin with a deep breath. Then tense your toes. Hold them like that for 5 seconds and relax them for 30. Move to your calves and thighs and do the same. Contract and relax. Continue to your abs and your backside. Move to your hands, then arms and shoulders. Don't rush. Go muscle by muscle and focus your mind on what you're doing. No external thoughts are allowed. Finally, work your chest, neck, and don't forget about your face. Tighten your jaw and then relax it. If that full body relaxation is too much for you, at least work out your toes as you lie in bed. Curling and uncurling them for a while is a great way to release tension from your entire body. It's repetitive, so your body is slowly moving into sleep mode. Plus, it works out your leg muscles and even your abs. A yoga instructor is passing by, and she also drops in a tip. Moon breathing is popular in many Asian countries to calm your nervous system and improve your sleep cycle. Just put a finger on your right nostril and breathe slowly and deeply through your left one. It slows you down before sleep or whenever you need to calm down quickly. You decide to visit your grandma. She'll definitely have some wisdom to share. Her first piece of advice is to always wear socks in bed. When you literally have cold feet, your blood vessels grow narrow. When your feet are warm and cozy, the circulation gets back to normal. Your brain receives a signal. It's bedtime. One more time-tested trick from Grandma is to make your pillow smell like lavender. It's a natural sleep aid. You can spray your pillow with it 10 minutes before bed. If you don't want oil stains on your linen, you can put it in the washing machine on laundry day. You'll need to fix 20 drops of lavender oil with 1.5 ounces of filtered water for this one. You get home and put on a podcast on psychological sleep tricks while cooking your Brinner. It says the right way to distract and calm down your brain is to make meaningless lists in your mind. You can plan what you'd take with you on vacation to space or how you'd decorate your restaurant. You can get up and write down what's bothering you to clear your mind of it. You should get rid of the habit of watching the clock when you can't fall asleep. Every time you look at it, your brain sees it as a wake prompt. So set the alarm and put it somewhere you can't see it. You don't have to know how many hours you have before it goes off. You quickly get used to this process and might wake up at night just for that. You can also try tricking your mind and stop trying to get to sleep at all. When your mind feels comfortable about staying awake, the stress about falling asleep will be gone, and you'll easily do it. Cleaning the mess in your bedroom also helps. The more clutter around you, the more likely you'll have sleeping issues. When your brain has the visual image of all that mess, it adds a task to the subconscious to-do list for that day. It won't rest properly until you've cleaned the mess. It's time to go to bed again. Studying all the techniques made you so tired, it looks like you don't need to use any of them tonight. You fall asleep like a baby.